بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين، آمين. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم، ولا فهم لنا إلا ما فهمتنا، إنك أنت البر الرحيم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا أفرغ علينا صبرا وتوفنا مسلمين. الحمد لله رب العالمين. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins, to accept our a'mal, and to help us inshallah to be among the good doers and to be among the righteous Muslims inshallah bi'idhnillah. Inshallah, we will continue our tafsir program. And tonight, inshallah, bi'idhnillah, after finishing Surah Al-Kawthar and Surah Al-Ma'un last time, we will, inshallah, start tonight in Surah Quraysh and Surah Al-Fil, inshallah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Quraysh, لإيلاف قريش إيلافهم رحلة الشتاء والصيف فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف. The translation will be: at least for the favors of making Quraysh secure, God's major favor to the Meccans, at least for the favor of making Quraysh secure in the trading caravan to Yemen in the winter and Syria in the summer, let them worship the Lord of this sacred house who has fed them against hunger and made them secure against fear. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning in this surah is about Quraysh, and Quraysh, as we know, the tribe from which our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning his favors, one of his favors on Quraysh. And he subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, لِإِلَى فِي قُرَيْشِ إِلَى فِيهِمْ رِحْلَةَ الشِّتَاءِ وَالصَّيْفِ. We will explain in detail the meaning of these words. But he subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning the favor that he subhanahu wa ta'ala has enabled Quraysh, the tribe of Quraysh, to go to travels, one in the winter time and one in the summer time, to Syria and to Yemen. And these are trading business or trading caravans going in winter and summer. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed them with that. And he subhanahu wa ta'ala secured them from any jua', any hunger, and any khawf, any fear. Because he subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Lord of the sacred house in Mecca, and they are blessed because of that sacred house in Mecca. And we will see that what the ulama of tafsir, al-Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, al-Imam Jalaluddin al-Qasimi rahimahumullah, and other imams, what they say in the tafsir of this ayah. First, about the favors of Quraysh, أخرج الحاكم والطبراني والبخاري في التاريخ عن أم هانئ بنت أبي طالب قالت قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فضل الله قريشا بسبع خصال. البخاري in his book history and الحاكم and الطبراني they narrate one of the hadith, and سيدة أم هانئ بنت أبي طالب, she is the one who heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored the tribe of Quraysh with seven favorites or seven qualities they have been given, no one else was given. فضلهم بأنهم عبدوا الله عشر سنين لا يعبد الله إلا قرشي, أي لا يعبده وحده من العرب إلا قرشي. First one of these seven, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala favored Quraysh because it was 10 years that all who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they came from the tribe of Quraysh. The first muwahids, the first Muslims who said La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. For 10 years, all these people were from the tribe of Quraysh. So this is one of the great benefits and favors Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to the tribe of Quraysh. Second, وَفَضَّلَهُمْ بَأَنَّهُ نَصَرَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْفِيلِ وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ أي نصرهم على قوة تفوق قوتهم كثيرا بما يشبه نصره لرسله في كونه بدون استعداد كسبي يقرب أو يقرب من استعداد عدوهم. الله سبحانه وتعالى second favor on Quraysh, that he subhanahu wa ta'ala made them victorious in the story of Al-Fil, the elephant. And we will notice in Surah Al-Fil, which we will say next inshallah, the story of Al-Fil, that we know that Abraha came with the elephant to destroy the Kaaba, and this was before the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born. This was the same year the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born on. He was born 50 days, as the ulama said, 50 days after the story of Al-Fil. So they were still mushriks. They worship Asnam and Awthan and other things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them victorious against Abraha because of the bayt of the Kaaba, the sacred house. So this is the second favor. The third one, وَفَضَّلَهُمْ بَأَنَّهُ نَزَلَ فِيهِمْ سُورَةٌ مِّنَ الْقُرْآنِ. And another favor is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed a specific surah named Surah Quraysh, which that we read in the Quran. So since Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inherited that wallet until the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, the name of Quraysh is mentioned in the Quran. And when people read that surah, they are coming close from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a form of ibadah when they read Surah Quraysh. And this is a favor Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to that tribe. Number four, وَفَضَّلَهُمْ بِأَنَّ فِيهِمُ النُّبُوَّةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored them and he gave them the prophethood. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a man from the tribe of Quraysh. وَالْخِلَافَةِ. The Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and Ali, all these, they come from Quraysh. So Al-Khilafah was there in the tribe of Quraysh. وَالْحِجَابَةِ وَالْسِقَايَةِ. Al-Hijabah means serving the Kaaba, cleaning the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, having the keys and helping people if it has any maintenance or something, the issues. So Quraysh, they are the ones who are doing the maintenance of Al-Kaaba, and they are the only ones having access to go inside the Kaaba. And this is another favor. And the last one, As-Siqaya, they give the water and drinks and help during the season of Hajj when the pilgrims come to Mecca. So these are seven favors Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given Quraysh. One of them that he subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed a surah is named Surah Quraysh. And then when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, لِإِلَى فِي قُرَيْشِ, the word لإلاف قريش, علماء say أي لإتلافهم واجتماعهم في بلدهم آمنين, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning in the beginning of the surah the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that tribe of Quraysh, that he subhanahu wa ta'ala made them together and they have a community inside of them, the tribe of Quraysh. They love each other, they stand for each other, and they are safe and secure. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning this favor in the beginning of the surah, and then by the end of the surah, he subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask them to do something because he subhanahu wa ta'ala is favoring them with that. He subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking them to do something. So لإله في قريش وقيل إله في قريش أي الفهم الخروج إلى الشام في تجارتهم وقيل أن يؤلف الشيء إلى الشيء فيألفه ويلزمه. So the first word, لِإِلَافِ قُرَيْش, أَلِفَ يَأْلَفُ, from which comes لِإِلَافِ قُرَيْش. It means something that comes together. Someone, أَلِفَ, someone else, means that he is acquainted with him. He knows him well, and they come together, and they share many of the characteristics. So they come together in many of things they think about. So this is the إِلَاف. And also it was said, إلاف قريش أي الفهم الخروج, الفهم that they like to go out during the summer time and the winter time in two different businesses with the caravans to Syria and to Yemen, and they like that. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easy for them. So it is also another meaning of the إلاف, the إلاف قريش. وقيل المراد بذلك أي الإلاف قريش ما كانوا يألفونه من رحلة الشتاء والصيف في المتاجر وغيرها. فمن عرفهم احترمهم ومن سار معهم أمن بهم. So when they go to Yemen and Sham, Syria, in their businesses, whoever they meet on the way, people feel safe and secure when they see the tribe of Quraysh moving on the way. Because this is a respected tribe. And if somebody is not secure and safe, when he or she meets some group of Quraysh, he or she feels safe and secure. So this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them this favor. And هذا حالهم في أسفارهم ورحلتهم في شتائهم وصيفهم. وأما حال إقامتهم في البلد وهي مكة فكما قال الله أولم يروا أنا جعلنا حرما آمنا ويتخطف الناس من حولهم. وقال أيضا لإيلاف قريش إيلافهم وهو مفسر للأول ولهذا قال رحلة الشتاء ورحلة الصيف. وقال ابن جرير اللام في لإيلاف قريش للتعجب كأنه يقول اعجبوا لإيلاف قريش ونعمتي عليهم في ذلك. So the علماء, they come into details to speak about the word لإيلاف قريش. Because it is not a regular word that Arabs use too much. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he reveals the Quran, he subhanahu wa ta'ala is very selective. And he subhanahu wa ta'ala also uses the accurate, the most accurate word in the best position, in the best form, when it is needed, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this word has lots of meanings, and we can take it, like make a summary out of that. لإيلاف قريش. Some of the ulama said it is about going to Yemen and going to Sham or Syria. In these two businesses, they have become accustomed to that and they like it, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it good and easy and secure for them. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to tell the people who read that story about Quraysh, this is something amazing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed his ni'mah on that tribe of Quraysh, and he subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling them, you can see my ni'mah on you. And وروى ابن جرير عن عكرمة قال كانت قريش قد ألفوا بصرى واليمن يختلفون إلى هذه في الشتاء وإلى تلك في الصيف. And this is what we just explained. Then the second آية لإيلاف قريش then إيلافهم رحلة الشتاء والصيف. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after that is saying فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت. So let them worship the Lord of that or this house, which is the house of Allah, which is Al-Ka'bah. أي إن نعم الله تعالى على قريش غير محصورة فإن لم يعبدوه لسائر نعمه عليهم فليعبدوه لهذه النعمة الجليلة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored Quraysh with many things. If they don't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those favors that he has given them, let them worship him alone just because of that ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving them, that they are safe and secure going to these business trades in summer and in winter time, and they should be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that. فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. وقال الإمام ابن كثير رحمه الله ثم أرشدهم إلى شكر هذه النعمة العظيمة فقال فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ فَلْيُوَحِدُوهُ بِالْعِبَادَةِ كما جعل لهم حرما آمنا وبيتا محرما كما قال تعالى إنما أمرت أن أعبد رب هذه البلدة الذي حرمها وله كل شيء وأمرت أن أكون من المسلمين. الإمام ابن كثير رحمه الله is saying in this tafsir when it comes to فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت, he is saying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is guiding the tribe of Quraysh to thank the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the great ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he has given them, so they should worship him alone subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he made for them a safe and secure place and sanctuary in Mecca, which is Al-Ka'bah, to which everyone comes, and whoever will reach that place will be safe and secure. So they should be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving them that. الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف. So these are, this is the last ayah. أي هو رب البيت الله سبحانه وتعالى the Lord of that house كعبة وهو الذي أطعمهم من جوع and he سبحانه وتعالى is the one who fed them when they are hungry وآمنهم من خوف he is the one سبحانه وتعالى who gave them safety and security when everybody else is afraid أي تفضل عليهم بالأمن فليفردوه بالعبادة وحده لا شريك له ولا يعبدوا من دونه صنما ولا ندا ولا وثنا So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving them this ni'am, having the Kaaba and being safe and secure, and they have no worry about anything, because the other tribes during that time used to have many wars. They wage wars against each other, and they declare wars for small and little things, and they kill people and they shed blood for small things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved that tribe from that. And this is for a reason we will know later, which inshallah we'll talk about it in Surah Al-Fil also. The reason is that Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is coming from that tribe. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is honoring that tribe because of him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, ولهذا من استجاب لهذا الأمر جمع الله له بين أمن الدنيا وأمن الآخرة. So whoever answers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he says فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ they should worship the Lord of that house Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them security and safety in this life and in the afterlife وَمَنْ عَصَاهُ سَلَبَهُمَا مِنْهُ كَمَا قَالَ تَعَالَى وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ آمِنَةً مُطْمَئِنَّةً يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ لِبَاسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ بِمَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ And the ones who are not thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for these favors, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take these ni'am from him or her, which is or which are ni'matul amn, the favor of security, and also to be fed and other people are hungry. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this in another ayah, that the example of a city that was secure and safe and we sent our rizq to the people there and when they made kufr they did not say la ilaha illallah they insisted on shirk and being like polytheists or being abadatul asnam to worship the idols Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he said fa'adhaqaha Allah libas al-ju' wal-khawf Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent two types of azab which is al-ju' hunger and al-khawf fear. So if you cannot get what you eat, this is a big and serious catastrophe in the community. And if you have money and you have influence, but you do not feel safe in your homeland, this is another danger that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send for those who will listen to the ayat and they do not apply them and they do not implement them in their lives. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is revealing this surah and he's mentioning his favor on that tribe, the tribe of Quraysh, and he subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking them, once I gave you all these favors, you should submit yourselves to me alone and you shouldn't go back. And if you do, I will send two of my weapons or two of my soldiers, which are hunger and also the sense of insecurity or the non-secure place or non-secure environment. وقال الإمام جلال الدين القاسمي رحمه الله الذي أطعمهم من جوع أي جوع شديد كانوا فيه قبل الرحلتين أي أنعم عليهم وأطعمهم لإزالة الجوع عنهم. الإمام جلال الدين القاسمي one of the big scholars of tafsir and his name His book name is Mahasin al-Ta'wil, the beautiful tafsir of the Quran. So also you can go back and look him up. Jalal al-Din al-Qasimi is one of the books that many scholars recommended. He said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who fed the tribe of Quraysh. When they are very hungry, he subhanahu wa ta'ala sent them these two trips to Yemen and to Syria. So they go and make business and they make money and they eat. So nobody is starving after these two business caravans. So this is one of the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ أي مما يخاف منه من لم يكن من أهل الحرم من الغارات والحروب والقتال والأمور التي كانت العرب يخاف بعضها من بعض. وقال ابن زيد: كانت العرب يغير بعضها على بعض ويسبي بعضها بعضا، فآمنوا من ذلك لمكان الحرم، أي لوجود الحرم عندهم. وقرأ: أولم نمكن لهم حرما آمنا يجبى إليه ثمرات كل شيء. ونظيره أيضا قوله تعالى: أولم يروا أن جعلنا حرما آمنا ويتخطف الناس من حولهم. So the Imam is trying to give also a summary of قول الله تعالى: وآمنهم من جوع، الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف. آمنهم من خوف is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who took them away from all these fights that other tribes are going through, and the tribe of Quraysh, they are safe and secure, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving them this because of the specialty they have, which is Mecca, and also more specifically is Al-Ka'bah, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sanctuary of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed in that city, the city of Mecca, and he subhanahu wa ta'ala called it Al-Balad Al-Amin, the safe and the secure city or country, because of the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being there. So this is Surah Quraysh. So now Quraysh, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given us a summary, it has many favors, and one of them, this surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the surah, it's named Quraysh, and it is the tribe from which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes from. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put the prophethood and the khilafah and serving the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also maintaining the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that specific tribe, the tribe of Quraysh. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning his favor upon them and asking them, I am giving you all these favors, so you should worship just me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because I am the one who fed you after you were starving by giving you these two trips, and I am the one who has made you secure and safe while many other tribes are fighting and shedding blood. So this is just the summary of that surah, Surah Quraysh. We will move inshallah to Surah Al-Fil. Surah Al-Fil, it is related to Surah Quraysh. Al-Fil is the elephant, and Quraysh is the tribe of Quraysh in Mecca. And the story of the elephant, which we will mention inshallah in the surah, that's why the surah is called the Surah of the Elephant or Surah Al-Fil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعْلَ رَبُّكَ بِأَصْحَابِ الْفِيلِ أَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ كَيْدَهُمْ فِي تَضْلِيلٍ وَأَرْسَلَ عَلَيْهِمْ طَيْرًا أَبَابِيلَ تَرْمِيهِمْ بِحِجَارَةٍ مِّن سِجِّيلٍ فَجَعَلَهُمْ كَعَصْفٍ مَأْكُولٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in the translation here, have you not seen, O Prophet, how your Lord dealt with the army of the elephant? Did he not frustrate their scheme? For he sent against them flocks of birds that pelted them with stones of baked clay, leaving them like chewed up straw. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here is speaking about the story of the elephant. And it is a very long story. We will try to make it as short as we can, but also we shouldn't miss the basics of that story. We know Surah Al-Buruj, just Amma or Surah Al-Buruj, which talks about the story of the people of Ahlul Ukhdud, the people of the trench, that the king, he was telling the people, you should worship me, and they said no, and he dug trenches in the city, and he put fire in these trenches, and then he threw everybody who says La ilaha illallah. And if you remember the story of the boy, the young boy, at that time, the king wants to kill him, and then he couldn't until he took one arrow from the boy's arrows, and he said, Bismillah Rabbil Ghulam, in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the boy. Oh, this story, the king of that time was called Dhu Nawas. The king who is mentioned in Surah Al-Buruj is called Dhu Nawas. And that king was in Yemen also. He was ruling Yemen at that time. And he's the one who killed these people, the Mu'mins, in trenches. And the ulama said he killed around 20,000 Muslims, putting these trenches and putting the fires and then throwing the mu'mins who said La ilaha illallah in these trenches of that time. And then a few people survived. One of these people, his name was Daws Dhu Tha'laban, one of the survivors of this tragedy. And he fled to Malik al-Sham, the king of Syria of that time. And he was a Christian king. And he told him that Dhu Nawas, that king, he is killing everybody. He is putting everybody in the fire. And we need some help. So he survived from that, the trenches. And he went to the king of Syria to ask him help. The king of Syria, he wrote to him a book to get to Al-Najashi. Al-Najashi of that time was the king of Al-Habasha. Habasha is Abyssinia. Because he was closer to Yemen. And then Al-Najashi, when he got that book from the king of Syria, he sent two princes with that man to help the people of the trench in Yemen. Those two princes' names are Yat and Abraha. So we just focus here, because Abraha is the one that we are talking about. When we mention the story of Al-Fil, the elephant, it always comes with the king Abraha. So Abraha was sent by Al-Najashi. Al-Najashi is the king of Abyssinia, Al-Habasha. Al-Najashi was a Christian king. You remember Al-Najashi is the one who accepted Islam in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then when he died, he is the only man that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed janazah while he is absent, was Al-Najashi. Najashi is the only man that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed janazah on, because he was in Abyssinia and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in Medina. So when he knew that he died, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed janazah, and he was the imam with the Sahaba, and he's the only one, it's the only one that Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did so with, was the king of Al-Habasha of that time, Abyssinia. So that king sent two princes to help these people of Yemen. One of them is Ariad and the other one is Abraha. And then when they went to Yemen, they killed the king who was ruling there, and they took over. And then finally, Abraha and Ariad, they tried to take the influence, and they have some problems between themselves. So they said, instead of having our army to go and fight against each other, we just have to fight each other, both of us, Ariad and Abraha. And whoever wins will take over Yemen. So Ariad was winning, and he hit Abraha on his face, and he split his nose and his lips, and he was about to kill him. But Abraha's servant came to Ariad and killed him from behind. So at that time, Abraha was the survivor, and he was crowned the king of Yemen at that time. So Al-Najashi, he knew that story, that they fight together, and he killed Ariad. Al-Najashi became very angry with them. He sent them for a specific mission, and they are killing each other. So Abraha wants to win Al-Najashi. So he sent him, you know, I'm sorry, whatever you want from me, I will do. And you know what, in Yemen here, in Sana'a, Sana'a is one of the big cities of Yemen, we are going to build a church for you. And we will make it the most beautiful church that people will come and visit. So Al-Najashi was pleased with that, and he left him on Yemen at that time. So the story here will come closer to what we talk about, which is the story of Al-Fil, the elephant. Abraha, he built the church in Yemen, and he made it very high and very beautiful. And not too many people come to the church. And he's asking why people don't come. He was told because the Arabs have Al-Kaaba, and everybody comes to visit Al-Kaaba. So Quraysh at the same time, they knew of that, and the Arabs knew of that, and they were very angry because Abraha is building a house that will compete with Al-Kaaba. So one of the Arabs went there at night and they have a plan. And then after, he went into that church and he just like did something bad in the church. So in the morning, when they opened the church, they found this on the ground. They said, this is something disgusting. Who did this inside the holy church? So they told Abraha, these must be the Arabs because they are hating us because we have that church and people will come to us and leave Al-Kaaba. So it must be the Arabs. So Abraha decided, I will go and destroy that house in Mecca and I will not leave one brick. I will destroy it all together. And he started to prepare his army to go to Mecca to destroy Al-Kaaba. So from here we will know the story of Al-Fil. And he has some elephants in his army going towards Al-Kaaba to destroy Al-Kaaba because he wanted his house, his church that he built in Sana'a in Yemen just to be the only house so people can come and visit so and they can pay money and they can do things as they do in Mecca and the people of Yemen become famous and he becomes famous and Al-Najashi in Abyssinia will be pleased with him. So this was his plan. But when he knew that some of the Arabs came and some of the ulama said some people set fire in the church, they came at night and they put the church into fire. And some other ulama said, no, somebody did what he does in the washroom inside of the church. And this was bad. And they said, we are going to destroy the Kaaba because Arabs are trying to insult us and insult our faith by doing this inside of the church. So he started going towards Mecca. And the first one he met about two or three people on the way who like Kaaba and like Mecca, and they do not want him to destroy the Kaaba. And they tried to fight him, but he won all of them because he had a very big army and he had some elephants and his people were very trained for war. So he won all of them until he reached Al-Kaaba. So when he wins every battle on the way to Al-Kaaba, he takes the head of the people who were fighting as a captive. So he took about two people captives and they were very highly respected in their lands. One of them is called Dhu Nafar, and also one of them also is called Nufayl ibn Habib al-Khaz'ami. These two people, they were the heads of their people who tried to fight Abraha because he is going to destroy the Kaaba. And the people in Mecca at that time are talking, and Abdul Muttalib, the Prophet's grandfather, he is the one who is in charge of Quraysh. He's the head of Quraysh. So they are talking about that. They're saying Abraha is coming to destroy the Kaaba. So Abdul Muttalib said, Abraha, he has a big army. We cannot fight him. We have no army and we cannot fight him. If he is coming to fight us, we are not going to fight him. And they are trying to see some plans. Some people of Quraysh said, no, we have to fight him. We have to spend all of our money and buy weapons and we have to fight him. He is coming to destroy the Kaaba. And if he destroys the Kaaba, our history will go away. So we have to stand up for the Kaaba. But Abdul Muttalib, he said, I'm not going to fight him. So he sent his people. He was very close from Mecca. He sent one of his people to Abdul Muttalib. He said, go and ask for the head of Quraysh and let him come to talk to me. So the man went. While he is going to Mecca to get Abdul Muttalib, he saw many camels on the way. So he took these camels. Among these camels, Abdul Muttalib has 200 of these. So that man that Abraha sent to Abdul Muttalib, he took all these camels. And then some of them were for Abdul Muttalib, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam grandfather. And then when he met Abdul Muttalib, he said, Abraha is here and he wants to talk to you. He said, if you want to fight, he is coming to destroy the Kaaba. If you are trying to defend the Kaaba, he is going to wage war against you. But if you leave him alone and the Kaaba, he will not kill anyone. He will go and destroy it. Then Abdul Muttalib went to Abraha to talk to him. Abraham was a king. He was sitting on a big throne, something like a bed. And then when he saw Abdul Muttalib coming from outside, Abdul Muttalib was a very big and tall man and was also a beautiful man. He was a very white man, white and red man. So when he saw him, he had some respect and some reverence to him. This was Abdul Muttalib. And then when they sat down and they started talking, Abdul Muttalib told him, "We are not fighting you." And he has a translator because they don't talk the same language. So the King Abraha is asking the translator, "Tell Abdul Muttalib, I am coming to destroy the Kaaba." And then Abdul Muttalib is saying to the translator, "Tell him to get me back the 200 camels that he got from me." So then Abraha is talking to the translator saying, "When I saw you for the first time, I respected you. But when you talk, you don't have any respect now from me, because I'm talking to you about the house that you worship. Your gods are there and everything is there. I'm talking to you about the Kaaba, and you are talking to me about hundreds of camels." Then Abdul Muttalib said his famous statement about the Ibil, and he said, "Inni ana Rabbul Ibil. I am the Lord and the owner of these Ibil, camels. أما البيت وإن البيت له ربا سيمنعه." But the house, the Kaaba, it has a Lord who will defend it. قال ما كان ليمتنع مني. Nobody will stop me from destroying it. Then Abdul Muttalib told him, قال أنت وذاك. So try and see what will happen. So this is the conversation between Abdul Muttalib and the King Abraha. He is coming to destroy the Kaaba. Abdul Muttalib is saying, "I care about my camels that you took. Give me back my camels." And then he's saying, "I'm coming to destroy the Kaaba." He said, "I am the Lord and the owner of the camels. And the house has a Lord who will defend it." And Abraha said, "I will go and destroy it." So Abdul Muttalib told him, "If you want, you can go." So at that time, Abdul Muttalib, he went back to his tribe and his people, and they went to the Kaaba, and now they know that Abraha is coming with the elephants to destroy the Kaaba. And they went in front of the door of the Kaaba, and they were asking God to help them against Abraha. And Abdul Muttalib said, like verses from the poetry are very famous ones. At that time when he was holding the handles of the door of the Kaaba, and he's asking Allah, the Lord of the Kaaba, to defend it. And he's saying, اللهم إن العبد يمنع رحله فامنع حلالك لا يغلبن صليبهم ومحالهم عدوا محالك إن كنت تاركهم وقبلتنا فأمر ما بدالك. So just these two verses from the poetry, he's saying, anyone will defend his mata, his money, his house. And those people of the cross are coming to destroy your house. And if you are going to leave them to destroy it, do whatever you want. He's talking to Allah. This is Abdul Muttalib. And after doing that, he got all the people and they went to the mountains, away from the Kaaba, to watch what will happen when Abraha comes into Mecca and tries to destroy the Kaaba. And we don't forget the two peoples that Abraha captured on his way. One of them is Nufail ibn Habib. These two people, they love Al-Kaaba so much and they love Mecca. That's why they tried to defend it and tried to kill and stop Abraha, but they couldn't. One of them was Nufail ibn Habib. Then Abraha came and he entered Mecca and he's about to go to Al-Kaaba. So Nufail, he came close from the elephant. The elephant was in the head of the army. And he went to the elephant and he held his ears. This is Nufail ibn Habib al-Khaz'ami. And he said in Arabic, "Ibruk, irji' rashidan min haythu ji't, fa innaka fi balad Allah al-haram." Nufail ibn Habib, he whispered in the elephant's ears, saying, "Sit down or go back. You are in the sanctuary of Allah." He is whispering in the elephant's ear these words, saying, "Stop or go back, you are in the sanctuary of Allah. You can see this. This is an animal. And he is whispering in his ears these things. Once he said that, he ran away. He went with Abdul Muttalib and his people on the mountains. Once he said that, the elephant stopped and sat down on the ground. And then they tried to get it up. It didn't go up. They used very sharp things, pointy things in the body of the elephant and even in his mouth and his throat. And he was bleeding, the elephant was bleeding. They tried to stimulate him to get up. He never got up. And then when they direct him to the other direction, he comes up running. But when they direct him to the Kaaba, he sits down and he never moves. Subhanallah, this is one of the miracles of the Kaaba and of the Quran and of Quraysh and Mecca. An animal that is coming to destroy the Kaaba, an animal doesn't know anything, but he is, or it is a creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us and animals and birds and everybody. And look at this man, Habib, who whispered in his ears, saying, go back or stop. You are in the sanctuary of Allah. Immediately, the elephant stops. And then they tried to stimulate him. They couldn't. They had some other elephants. So they came from another way. They tried to go to the Kaaba. And then they saw many birds coming from the horizon. And those birds are holding stones, one in their beaks and two in their feet. Each bird has three stones. And they tried to shoot Abraha army. And then the ulama said, when the birds came from the horizon, started shooting these stones, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the wind, and it was very strong, and it took these stones, and these stones, whomever fell on, tried to dissolve, the bodies tried to dissolve, not just injure the body, not just have a wound in the body started dissolving, the arms started to fall down from the body, and the feet tried to separate, and they said, Abraha, they got him, he was affected by these stones, and he was taken to Yemen, bleeding, and he did not die until his chest became open and his heart came out. You can imagine that. Abdul Muttalib was watching this, and the people of Mecca were watching this, and they were very happy. And everybody will go back to Abdul Muttalib, a famous saying, I am the Lord and the owner of the able, the camels, and the house has a Lord who will defend it. And they all believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even they are mushriks, they worship the idols, but they know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who is in the heavens, وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ Muhammad, if you ask them who created the heavens and the earth, they would say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they still worship these idols, and they say, مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَ. We just worship them to get us closer from Allah. But they knew the only one who can save them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why they made the dua for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Abdul Muttalib, and all the tribe of Quraysh, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent his soldiers, stopped the elephant, and he sent small birds. When we read the rest of the surah, أَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ كَيْدَهُمْ فِي تَضْلِيلٍ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, أَلَمْ تَرَى كَيْفَ فَعْلَ رَبُّكَ بِأَصْحَابِ الْفِيلِ Have you seen Muhammad, what your Lord has done with the people of the elephant? أَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ كَيْدَهُمْ فِي تَضْلِيلٍ Didn't he subhanahu wa ta'ala turn all their plans in vain? وَأَرْسَلَ عَلَيْهِمْ طَيْرًا أَبَابِيلَ That he subhanahu wa ta'ala sent birds in groups coming to them. تَرْمِيهِمْ بِحِجَارَةٍ مِّن سِجِّيلٍ And these birds are throwing them with some stones. فَجَعَلَهُمْ كَعَصْفٍ مَأْكُولٍ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made them like the tree leaves that are eaten or cut into too many pieces. You can see the ulama say, the last ayah in this surah, فَجَعَلَهُمْ كَعَصْفٍ مَأْكُولٍ The last part. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this is miraculous. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is like asf ma'kul, means it's like the leaf of the tree that is eaten or is cut off into many pieces. The similarity comes to the bodies of the people of Abraha army. Their bodies were just getting off. All the body parts are falling down. Their feet and their hands and all these toes and fingers, they fail off. They fall off from the body until these people get dissolved and they die the worst way of death because they came to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to destroy it. So you can imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning this to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he is making him aware sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of the story of the elephant, because that year, the year of the elephant, it was the year that Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is remembering these favors, and he is telling Quraysh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved you from that, and he subhanahu wa ta'ala also saved you from hunger and from insecurity. So worship him alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't worship anyone. But still some people from Quraysh did not accept Islam. And also, as we know, the Prophet's closest relatives, like Abu Talib, his uncle, the one who was helping him all the time, did not accept Islam. And many people did not accept Islam. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did his best to convey the da'wah to his relatives and to other people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتُ. You are not guiding whom you like or whom you love. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who guides whom he wills subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are the some of the ulama's notes, Al-Imam ibn Kathir and Al-Imam Jalaluddin al-Qasimi, about the two surah, Surah Quraysh, the tribe of Quraysh, and Surah Al-Fil, the elephant, and the story of the elephant, which are mentioned or is mentioned in every day when we talk about the elephant, but sometimes we don't know the details. We have to be aware of these details. Teach it to our families, our children. When we read these short surahs about Quraysh and about the elephant, we know what does it mean. It will make a big difference when we read the Quran and understand it. And this is the way of the Sahaba, radwanullahi alayhim. They read the Quran and they have seen the occasions during which the Quran was revealed, so that Iman was very strong. So when we know the real meaning of the Quran or behind the ayat, inshallah our Iman gets stronger and stronger. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins and to accept our deeds. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت عن حق أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا. أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وجزاكم الله خيراً.